The season premiere of Ryan Murphy's highly anticipated dram-com series, Scream Queens, aired last night, and let's just say there were enough murder scenes, comical one-liners, and Chanel characters to fill an entire Kappa house. Today's episode of Clevver Newsfeed is brought to you by The Mindy Project, an all-new season now available exclusively on Hulu. Okay, you guys, I'm just gonna throw it out there. I'm about to dish some major spoilers, so watch at your own risk, and also, while you're tuning in, you might want to watch your back for that Red Devil killer. So let's kick this Kappa party off with six of the most WTF moments from the premiere. But just as an FYI, I gotta throw out there, so much craziness went down, I just highly suggest that you tune in and watch it for yourself.
Let's make that a priority.
The series began with a complete bloodbath, but literally, because an old Kappa circa 1995 died post-giving birth while her sisters were dancing the night away to Waterfalls. But that's besides the point. I just wanted to let you guys know. Now, I am sorry to report that the first main character left us just far too soon. And I'll do you a favor, skip the skin-melting details about the spray tan death and the deep fryer death. But poor Chanel number two, AKA Ariana Grande, was the first victim of the Red Mask killer in what is sure to go down as the most politely executed murder ever. I mean, maybe she was just so in shock, or maybe she was really in the mood to dance. But either of those excuse the fact that before she thought to run, she attempted to tweet for help, but she was just 1 second from pressing send. It was just too late. After the Kappas found Chanel number two dead at the sorority house, a geeky Kappa pledge named Neckbrace, played by Lea Michele, perfectly but so disturbingly described how to dismember her body, causing us all to be haunted by headgear-bearing girls in all future years to come.
Here's what you should do. Pulverize her teeth, burn off her fingerprints, and disfigure her face. Once her body is unrecognizable, we can create an incision on her inner thigh and drain out all of her bodily fluids.
I gotta point out, it's only gonna get creepier, so let's just move on to the next death, which involves a lawnmower, a buried alive body, and you guessed it, the Red Devil killer. I won't go into too much detail, but as a hazing ritual, the pledges were helplessly buried neck deep into the ground, and the Red Devil drove a lawnmower right over deaf Taylor Swift. Another day, another bloodbath, R.I.P. Deaf T. Swift. And I have to hand it to Emma Roberts and her family of fur coats, because those totally inappropriate one-liners that made all the sense but no sense at the same time totally gave me life, and they definitely deserve to count as their own WTF moments, like this one.
What fresh hell is this?
And then there was also this one.
How did you get HPV? When were you in Mexico?
And this one.
I'm sorry, did I ask you to pull down my panties and blow a compliment up my butt? Nobody likes a suck-up Chanel number five.
I'm not gonna spoil the rest for you guys, so you're just gonna have to tune in. And just as all the mystery keeps building, angelic newbie pledge Grace starts catching the feeling bug for Pete the barista, but he may have more to do with all the murder mystery than we had hoped. She opens his dorm room closet to find the entire Red Devil killer costume, to which he responds, I'm a mascot. I'm sorry, a mascot of death? I'm kinda just gonna say that's a red flag. And finally, we cannot go without mentioning shirtless, weightlifting Nick Jonas, Obvi. He plays Boone, a gay pledge, and also the next Red Devil victim.
What am I supposed to be scared?
And just when we thought Boone was dead after seeing his throat being slit, which normally means you're dead, the episode ends when he wakes up, rips off the stick-on slit in his throat as he awaits the Red Devil's appearance. Up to no good, that one. But until next week, we will hopefully just be able to wait until we get more answers, all the answers we're looking for. So you guys, I know there were a ton more OMG, WTF, ew moments, and that's why it's your turn to do the talking. If you tuned in to the premiere of Scream Queens, let me know all your thoughts on the show. Which moments had you totally cringing, laughing, screaming? And you can let me know all of that right on down here in the comments section. And when you're done, don't forget to click right over here to check out a brand new episode of Totally Clevver that involves celebrity hair and ink blots and crazy, crazy shenanigans. Thanks so much for hanging out with me right here on Clevver News. I'm your girl, Jocelyn Davis, and I hope you guys are able to sleep after watching this. And right now, click to the left to see us try out a few weird Japanese foot stretching tools. Then click to the right for a new debatable where we fight for our favorite T-Swift song from 1989. And before you go, click here to check out the promo for The Mindy Project. And don't forget to watch season 4, now available exclusively on Hulu.